some exercises are easier one side versus two. A great example of that is bicep curls. However, things like deadlifts and other leg exercises can be a little bit harder. Hi, and welcome to E3 Strength. My name is Earl, and today we're gonna be going over a single side exercise, the kettlebell swing. This one gets dicey because whenever you do anything on one side, especially when you're holding with your upper body, you tend to twist. People are already afraid for their backs in the deadlift and the swing, so that can be a little scary. Let's try to make it a little less. Let's take a look at what we're gonna do. The traditional kettlebell swing starts with a hike. That's where you stand behind your kettlebell. You're gonna swing it, rise to meet it. You're gonna hit your arms right against your thighs. From this position, you're doing an explosive bridge. It's the exact same thing, flexing the glutes to power forward. That's how the traditional two-handed goes. Let's look at it and then break it into one side. So the same thing should be done with single side. I'm gonna have my other hand trace the same exact pattern, but go outside of my body versus inside. Another good thing to remember is the thumb should go to the inside of your inner thigh. If you do that, it creates space and a little more comfort mentally versus realistically, so that you can get the swing down without being worried of hitting yourself in the leg or anywhere else. So let's look at that. With my other hand just outside of the kettlebell, I'm gonna swing, rotate my thumb into my inner thigh, and do the same exact motion. So far, so good, right? The hard part comes when you're trying to alternate from side to side. With dumbbells and doing bicep curls, it's kind of easy. One, one. With a Romanian deadlift, you really probably wouldn't do that. So let's look into how we're gonna do this. So as I'm rotating from my thumb being inside of my body, as I come up, I'm gonna rotate into an overhand position. As I do, I'm gonna continue rotating until I have that hammer grip position. I'm just gonna pass the kettlebell to my other hand. Easier said than done, and it's gonna take some practice. The good thing is, if you drop it, the weight's way away from you, you won't get hurt. And best case scenario, you should drop it. You don't wanna end up trying to recover a swing, especially a weight that could be outside of your body. So, worst case scenario, let it fly. Hopefully no one's in front of you. So let's look at the alternating single arm swing. Same thing, swing inside. And that's how we do it. Now this one takes a lot of practice. The fundamentals are simple. Tracing with one arm really helps to square the shoulders, and there's still always gonna be a little torque, but it really helps to prevent that whole motion. So if that's done, one thing out of the way. The next thing is the pass. Practice makes perfect, and remember, with any of your kettlebell swing exercises, don't use too light of a weight. If you do, you have a potential for using your arms, and then you have shoulder injuries, and that's where actually you can end up not using your glutes and using your lower back. So weight does help in this exercise. I hope all this information has been helpful. If it has, please give us a like, a comment, or a share. And for any other information, you can reach out to us at e3strength.com. Thanks.